Namaste, welcome to Bhavna's Kitchen. As you can read here, I love cooking. Today I'm making the most requested recipe so far, Rajasthani sweet delicacy. So it's basically dessert and it's a Ghevar. Some utensils for preparing this recipe. Here are the ingredients to prepare the batter: 1 cup all-purpose flour, Maida, 1 cup water, 1/4 cup ghee, clarified butter, 1/4 cup milk. Food coloring optional, and I'm using yellow food color. To prepare the sugar syrup, I have 1 cup of sugar, 1/2 cup of water. Here are the ingredients for garnishing. So these ingredients are optional. Here I have nuts, slivered almond and pistachio, badam, pista, kesar, saffron and cardamom-ilaichi. Here are some special utensils that you will need to prepare this recipe. Deep frying pot, you can see that mine is very deep. Ladle, spoon, skewer, or if you have something like these that you can hold on to here and pick up your Ghevar. And if you are not sure of how to check sugar consistency, candy thermometer. So candy thermometer is optional if you are good at checking sugar syrup thread consistency. So the first step is to prepare the batter. Alright, so into this bowl, I'm going to take 1/4 cup of ghee, clarified butter. And so this is 1/4 cup. I can eyeball very well. If you are not good at measuring, use measuring cup. Now I have kept spoon in water, ice cold water, and into cold milk so that it makes easier for me to pour a little bit at a time and keep blending. To prepare the batter, you should use cold milk, milk from refrigerator, and ice cold water. If you can't find ice cold water, you can drop some ice cubes in water. I took cold water and still I put 1 cube of ice in it because I want really chilled water. Why do you want to use cold liquid? Well, when you use cold liquid, your Ghevar will come out nice and crispy. So I always use ice cold liquid. So 1 tablespoon of water, 1 tablespoon of milk, and now achi tarah se blend lijiye. I'm using this electronic hand blender just because I want to make the procedure a little faster, but definitely this job can be done with your hand as well. So I'm going to stir continuously. Okay, milk and water. So I'm going to keep doing until I see this mixture frothy, meaning that it becomes light and fluffy. If you do not have this electronic hand blender, you have to keep stirring like this until it becomes fluffy. So it works even with hands, so you don't have to worry at all. You see how easy it gets blended with ghee, milk and water. All right, now I can see that it looks fluffy. So at this point, I'm going to start adding flour, maida, not all of it, half of it, and then give it a good mix. You see how easy it blends? All right, the rest of the flour, maida. If you follow this process a little slowly, you will get nice, smooth batter. If you add all the liquid at once, your batter will be lumpy. Now I'm going to add rest of the milk and start blending. Now add water slowly and keep blending until you get smooth batter. You see how batter is forming nicely. I'm going to add more water and adjust the consistency of the batter now. You can add more water at any point of time, even later, to adjust the consistency of the batter. Now before I give final blend, I'm going to add this food color and saffron, kesar. So put this on the side a little bit, and I'm going to crush this saffron, kesar. You can take warm milk to dissolve, so when you fry, it will pick up its color. Okay, that's just enough. Alright, so this is ready. Again, bring back this batter over here. Here goes the food coloring, just a few drops. And kesar. Start blending again. You see how nice the color? Okay, so this is mixed well with hand even, you see that? Now, just a little bit more because I want an easy to pour consistency better. So just a little bit more water. Just firmly mix it. Now try batter with ladle spoon as well, whether you are easy to pour or not. Now you see that it's easy and it's easy to pour, nice and thin flow like that. Perfect. Alright, so the batter is ready. Now before I start frying Ghevar, I'm going to prepare sugar syrup. It is important that you prepare sugar syrup first. And here into this pot, I'm going to prepare the sugar syrup. So into this pot, sugar and water. Alright, so this pot is ready to go onto the stove. And I'm going to prepare single thread syrup. So let this come to the boil first. Now you see that the syrup is coming to the boil. And I'm going to use this candy thermometer, and single thread is about 220 to 222. So when it reaches to 222, I'm going to turn off the stove. Now you can bring down on a low to medium heat once it comes to the boil, and it's almost there. Or you can use your forefinger and thumb to check the consistency. Okay, so it has reached to 220, turn off the stove and remove from the stove. Alright, so sugar syrup is ready, batter is ready, and now I'm going to fry Ghevar outside. Because the pot I have, it doesn't stay good on this stovetop, so I'm going to use my outdoor stove, gas stove. So I'm going to prepare the frying pot. Into this frying pot I have taken oil, and I'm going to mix ghee into this oil. So basically I'm using mix of oil and ghee to fry Ghevar. But traditionally Ghevar is fried only in ghee, pure ghee, clarified butter, but this is my preference. And make sure to fill up more than half of this pot. Alright, so here I have everything ready, mix of oil and ghee. I'm going to heat up and make sure it's hot when you start pouring batter. And you have to be very careful, so I already have the gloves with me. And here is the sugar syrup I have ready and the batter. It's beautiful weather outside and I'm gonna have fun making this Ghevar. Now before I start frying, few tips to share with you. When you pour your batter, it's going to depend how big your pot is. It takes up to 2, 4, or 6 spoons of this batter to make one Ghevar. I have a very small pot, so I'm going to use maybe 2 spoons only. But if you have a big wide pot, then you're gonna use maybe 4 or 6. And it is important to keep interval of about 2 minutes between each spoon you pour into this pot, because you want to allow to settle down the first spoon that you pour into this. And I'm going to show you exactly what we are going to do. Now the mixture of oil and ghee is fuming, I can see that. So at this time I'm ready to pour my first ladle. Now you want to keep distance between this pot and your ladle, and it's gonna splash, so stay back and keep about 6 inches of distance between your pot and your ladle. And now very thin flow of batter in the center. Make sure you pour into the center. You see how oil and ghee came all the way up, even though my pot is very deep. So that's the reason you want to take deep, deep pot. Alright, so I'm done with my first ladle. Now I'm going to wait and allow this to settle down. Alright, I waited 2 minutes, and now again I'm going to pour one more ladle. You can try to blow from very far if it starts coming up. Okay, so that was my second spoon. Now allow it to fry completely. If you use only oil, then you may burn your Ghevar, which you don't want to be happen. So that's why I add ghee into oil. Alright, so this Ghevar is ready to come out. Wow, look at this. Alright, so look at this wonderful looking Ghevar. Looking so beautiful. Here I have this paper towel, and I'm going to allow this to rest for a little bit onto this paper towel. Look at the color even. This is the perfect texture of Ghevar. Beautiful looking Ghevars. I hope you heard all the tips that I shared outside when I was frying. If not, you can always visit my website for more tips and ideas. Now you must be thinking that I haven't soaked them into sugar syrup yet, but I just wanted to share one thing with you, that once you fry this Ghevar, you can store them just as it is in an airtight container, and they stay great up to a month even. So whenever you are ready to serve, you can make the sugar syrup and soak them into the sugar syrup and serve. Now these are very delicate, so when you even handle, you have to be very generous and do not fry this Ghevar when you have kids around you. Now I'm ready to drench this Ghevar into the sugar syrup. Make sure to keep this Ghevar about 5 minutes in sugar syrup so it absorbs sugar syrup nicely. So for now, I'm just going to soak these 3 Ghevars only, and rest I'm going to store. Now you see, like, as soon as I put even the finger, it cracks easily. And if you don't have sugar syrup enough, if it doesn't go completely inside sugar syrup, you're going to flip on the other side and again allow it to absorb about 5 minutes. So I'm going to do the same with all Ghevars. Traditionally, Ghevar is served with rabri and also decorated very well with dry nuts and also sometimes silver leaves. Warak, known as in India, is also used to decorate this Ghevar. But just as it is, they look beautiful as well. Today I prepared some rabri as well to go with this Ghevar. Alright, I have one Ghevar ready to come out and I'm going to show you how you can decorate. Alright, so here I have this Ghevar ready. Place onto the tray. On the top, you can pour a little bit of chilled rabri, then nut, flavored almond, badam, pistachio, pista, and here I have some ilaichi. I'm just going to, alright, so just coarsely ground cardamom, sprinkle on top, and if desired, you can use this warak on top. And warak silver leaves are very delicate, so when you use, make sure you use it very firmly, and I'm just going to use a little bit randomly in some places. Look at this now. After all this work, I am ready to dig into this yummy dessert. All your work is paid off when you eat this Ghevar. You will forget all those hard work, believe me. I really love to try difficult recipes, and it's a lot of fun to make difficult recipes. So this was about preparing Ghevar, Rajasthani delicacy. I hope I made it easier for you to prepare this recipe. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon with another great episode of cooking.